welcome.
You're on the lake! Did you guys have a nice swim? Well, this is Eva. She joined us later. It's been a good day. I filmed nothing. I was busy helping people learn. We did some wake surfing and some wakeboarding and some water skiing. But look at this water. We shouldn't have been water skiing. My dad's windsurfing. But like,
it's a blast.
Oh, it's a fun though. Peter, how was your day?
It was awesome.
Good morning. Everyone's gone. Everyone left last night. Spencer was driving the boat, which was very kind of him. Thanks, Spence. I spent the whole time at the back of the boat helping people. Spencer's still a much better teacher than me, so he was driving the boat and teaching them. And I was just there. I would toss them the rope. But we had a great time. For me, it started on Sunday. I got home and we went wake surfing. We tried the foiling thing again. It is not getting easier. I found these sunglasses in the boat. I've been wearing them all weekend. I texted a picture of them to Spencer because I figured they were one of his friends. And I was right, so I don't get to keep them. At least I didn't lose them in the lake after I told him I found them. Typically, if possible, morning is when you want to go out on the lake. Yesterday, it was hot and it was glass and it would have been so perfect. And I spent the whole morning and early afternoon watching it get cloudier and windier. But everyone who came out was a good sport and we went anyway. And they were legit learning to water ski while my dad was windsurfing with a foil, but still. For those of you who don't know, windsurfing, you want it to be very windy, and water skiing, you want it to be very calm. Those two don't usually happen at the same time. I think everybody who wanted to get in the water tried wake surfing. Heidi went wakeboarding. Deanne and Anne and Tavia all tried water skiing. And they were like, Laura, you should go water skiing. Teach me how to do it. And I was like, in these conditions. Steph got a nosebleed and then went again so we could get pictures of her with her epic nosebleed, and it was like bleeding down into her teeth. It was so good. And then we had barbecue. I meant to film more once we got back to shore, but it turns out barbecuing for like a dozen people is busy. Also, my mom did most of it. I don't know what I was doing, but I was also busy. And then we had a campfire. I'm so glad people came out. And one car, so in the group event, I went to Google Maps and I found our address, and then I posted a link to the pin of where it was. So all they had to do was like use Google Maps, and it would have taken them right there. The night before and then the morning of, the two different people who were driving were like, I'd like directions. So then I typed out directions and I sent them to them. And our house, there's not a lot of signage, and there's some gravel roads, and it's a bit tricky. People get lost constantly. So one car made it. The other car did make it eventually, but they definitely made some wrong turns. They say it's not my fault, but I don't know. And then I got a message from Heidi this morning because apparently on their way home, the gas light came on just outside Stettler, but they didn't think that there was gas stations in Stettler. So they went on to Big Valley, where they realized that the gas station was closed because of course it was. They left super late. So then they went back to Stettler and they managed to find the last gas station, and it was still open, but only for like 15 minutes. And then there was a thunderstorm that they'd been ahead of, but then caught up to them. And anyway, so they got home at like 1, but I'm super glad they came. I hope that didn't ruin their night. Birds. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for new videos every Tuesday and Friday. Oh no. I found a dead fish. I feel confident in saying that wasn't there yesterday.